everybody. This is Adam Gusso, the good doctor from the University of Mississippi Department of English Program in Southern Studies. If you're watching this, either you're a subscriber to or a visitor to my Modern Blues Harmonica channel, which began back in 2007, or you're somebody who's gotten here maybe because my publisher, the University of North Carolina Press, wants to tell you about my new book. So I want to tell all of you briefly about my new book. The book is called Who's Blues? Facing Up to Race and the Future of the Music. Very briefly, what is it about? Well, it's a book designed to stage a conversation about two contemporary ways that people ideologize the blues. And already your eyes are glazing over. The first is the phrase, and they're memes. The first is the phrase, blues is black music. The second is the phrase, no black, no white, just the blues. I'm interested in the fact that that's how the contemporary conversation about this music has gone. Why has it gone there? Well, it's gone there partly because where the music's come from isn't exactly where it's gone. Where it's come from is the Black South. It's come from 1890s and early 1900s. It's come from men with guitars, classic blues women in sequined gowns with fronting jazz bands. It's come from the blues men and the blues women, black Southerners, black some migrant black Southerners to the big cities where they made some of their records. But where's it gone to? Well, at a certain point in the 1960s, between 1960 and 1970, the blues audience went from being mostly black, overwhelmingly black, to mostly white. It's a very strange thing that happens during the 1960s. And we are living in the year 2020 in the sort of aftermath period of both of those dynamics. And we're trying to make sense of it. And that's what I try to do in Who's Blues. It's got 30 photographs. Samantha Fish, Corey Harris, Sugar Blue, Mark Muleman Massey, Ma Rainey's Black Bottom, sheet music for Shaking the Blues Away, David Honeyboy Edwards, Ty Himba Jess, James Sun Thomas and Walter Liniger, the Holmes Brothers, Bessie Smith, the author, and Sterling, Mr. Satan McGee. What do you mean by that? Well, I'm writing the book partly as a guy who's been part of interracial blues duos for a long time, so I think I feel the call of beloved community as expressed through that weird and troubling and problematic phrase, no black, no white, just the blues. But I want to help readers, no matter who you are, understand where the blues has come from. So I'm going to try to honor the call of that phrase, blues is black music, even while acknowledging that the blues has come from there and gone to become a global music. One of the people I write about is Ken Sugar Brown Kawashima, the Korean-Japanese, his mother was Korean, his father was Japanese, Korean-Japanese-American, now living in Canada, blues guy with a Chicago street harmonica guitar pedigree. This guy, he's played in the black community in Chicago, as I did play in the streets in Harlem. Let me just say something more briefly about the book, which is that it's not just about where the blues came from and what our contemporary scene is. And by the way, the very last photo in the book, Aki Kumar, born in Mumbai, mentored by wonderful harmonica players in California. He's now one of the top guys on the scene, and he has heightened his ethnic self-presentation, which is a professor's way of saying that during the Trump administration, he decided he just needed to be honest about the fact that he was an Indian-American guy, not just an American guy. And he's a radical in a wonderful way, and I talk about his music. Public date is October 19th. Who's Blues? Facing Up to Race and the Future of the Music. It's just a rich, rollicking mix. It's a stew, and it really is where the blues world is right now. It is also very frank. And if you don't like thinking about the blues and race at the same time, if you're that kind of white blues pastoralist, might not be the best book for you. Then again, it might be. It might be exactly the book you need to kind of come up to speed and get a lot of really interesting stuff. So go and order it from the publisher, UNC Press, University of North Carolina Press, or go to Amazon. Do one of those things. But by all means, read it. It's the book that people are going to be talking about. Thank you for spending time with me. I wish I had a song for you, but